Okay, I'm taking a broken baseball bat, and I'm going to turn it into a goblin. Turning up the speed a little. Now what I'm going to do is measure the depth, which it's 3 9/16. So now I'm going to take and measure over 3 9/16 and make a mark. 3 9/16 and make a mark. Then what I'm going to do, I'm going to come down here like this. Scribe that in. That shows me the bottom of where I have just bored my hole too. So then what I like to do is I'm going to go down here and mark my base. I'm going to be able to part it right there. And I'm going to mark my base about a half an inch. That'll include a taper. Something like that. Then I come down here, and I have a floating ring, and another floating ring, and there we go. Okay, now I'm going to do a little smoothing on the inside between the two layers of boring that I did, because I did a step bore inside where the first drill bit was larger. The second drill bit in here, because it tapers a little, is a little smaller, so I'm going to blend those two in. 1000 RPM. unfortunately, I just cut the first ring free. I wasn't planning on doing that quite yet, but I did. Luckily, I sanded it already. So now I'm going to get ready to do the next one. Sand it. Okay, and here we go. We're going to cut it now. So I'm going to shape the bottom. Okay, now I'm going to oil it. Healthy amount of oil. Now we turn it on. Okay, and it's just about to come off. I'm going to shear it off into my hand. There it is. Finished flute with captive rings. So here's the finished product. The captive rings on the goblet. Nice and deep. Beautiful color.